is Víctor, and I came from University of Göttingen. So I would like to thank to the organizing committee that they decided to accept my submission as a flash talk, because I don't have any result yet to present, but this is a great opportunity for me to present the project and also to know this EpiDiverse Network. So maybe it's this one? Or... Yeah. So as you may know, Norway spruce is probably one of the most important species in Europe due to its high value as source of bioenergy, wood and forestry product. Also, demand of wood with a specific trait is expected to be increasing in the future, because now this supply is threatened by new climate condition, and also this new pests and disease or the absence of the old ones. So this push to the forest industry to include these new traits in their breeding programs. But traditional breeding program in tree breeding program, it's unknown for a long generation times and also elevated cost. So we need to accelerate tree breeding, and selection based on genome wide markers is one of the ways to reduce, to increase biomass production, reducing breeding cycles. So in this project, we plan to dissect the genetic and epigenetic basis of wood quality traits in Norway spruce through the combination of genetic studies and genome-wide markers associated to new physical and chemical properties, disease resistant, decay resistant, or hardwood extractives. Also, we plan to develop novel tools to assist the genetic improvement of breeding, and also to analyze the feasibility of genomic selection in conifer trees. So this project integrates the research activities of all the participant groups and comprehends 5 working packages, including the phenotyping screening of novel traits, also the study of the role of chemical compounds in good and candidate genes, also in good quality and decay resistant, genetic resistant against Drosophila infection, also changes in the expression profile in response to different new environmental conditions, and finally in the working package 5, which is the one that I will present now. We will integrate this result, and we will ask how GWAS can be used to locate major genetic and epigenetic markers associated to specific phenotypes, and also whether genomic selection is effective to predict disease resistance and good quality. So in the phenotyping phase of the project, new novel traits were described using a large sample size, and the DNA extracted from this plant were then used for the genotyping and epigenotyping phase. So for the genotyping, 55,000 proofs covering about 35 genes were designed and hybridized with the genomic DNA targeting the exome, which was then captured and sequenced using Illumina technology. But also this DNA was treated with bisulfite, converting the non-methylating cytosines into uracils, and then hybridized with 193,000 proofs representing the non-exon sequencing, but also potential methylation schemes in both strands, cis and trans. So I have received the sequencing data a few weeks ago. So far, the computational analysis have included just the pre-processing of raw reads. And also right now, these reads are being mapped against the reference genome available for Norway spruce. Then we will perform the variant calling to identify the SNPs. And also with the information provided by the bisulfite treatment, we will do methylation calling and differential methylation analysis between regions and samples. And then this is repeating all the same, but we will perform GWAS to interrogate these genetic and epigenetic variants, how the association with the phenotypes, and also we will develop this genomic the model, predictive model for genomic selection. And that's all. This is the partners and collaborators of the project, like Frelda Siekbu and Chimuteri from the University of Helsinki, Iva Terhonen from the Forest Pathology Group in Göttingen, Oliver Galing, Konstantin Krutowski, also partners like Matti Havanen in Luke in Finland. Thank you very much for your attention.